it's Nate. What's up? I am in my room and I decided to do a talking, let's sit down in front of the camera kind of video for you guys because it's already Monday and I have to post every Monday, Wednesday, Friday and I don't have a video for today, so I am winging it. Just kidding. I am on my skateboard right now. I sat on it and that's why I rolled into the frame. And if you guys are wondering how I did it, whoa, Nate, how did you do that? I just rolled into the frame using my skateboard and I am also by my bookshelf. So that's my bookshelf right there. You can see my different books. I actually have a bunch more books. I have a whole lot more books here outside, right here. It's not very well lit, but there's a lot of books. My child books, the books that I used to read as a kid, some other really useful books like this. James Patterson, I remember this book. This right here is a solid book. But anyway, that is not really what I want to talk to you guys about today. What I am here for is to show you 5 must-read books that you must read before you die. That was a redundant statement. I don't know. At this point, I don't know what my title is gonna be, but it's already there on the video, so you see it. Also, update on my singaw. I still cannot talk or smile very well, so sorry if I look very weird or serious or poker-faced or sad or angry at you guys. I'm not angry. It just kind of sort of hurts to be talking. That's why I'm also gonna make this video a quick video. So anyway, enough delays, let's get started. I picked 5 books for you guys that I think, oh by the way, product placement. Elements and Seasons makes really good jewelry. Thank you so much for this. I don't usually wear rings, but if there was one symbol that I could have engraved on a ring, it would be this one. Sorry, my fingernails are boy fingernails. They don't look really. But it's cool. Go check them out. Why am I so awkward today? So here's a quick look at the back of all these books. I will be explaining them one by one. I tried to make sure that they weren't all fiction, they weren't all stories, they weren't all just non-fiction, they weren't all, like, there's a little bit for everybody. I know it's only 5 choices, but I tried to put some variety into it for you guys. So number 1, The Chronicles of Narnia by C.S. Lewis. Actually, these are 7 books. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I guess the video's done. Let's use the Carpe Diem together, guys. Bye! No, I'm just kidding. The Chronicles of Narnia are 7 amazing, enchanting, magical storybooks about a magical land created by a lion and how children, as they grow up, encounter the land and how it changes their lives and how they change Narnia. And of course, if you are a Christian, there are lots of amazing things to be learned about your relationship with God and how that works and how much He loves you. And it's one of my favorite, probably my favorite book series in the world. So much that in my room, I have a painting of Aslan. Thank you so much, Miko. Chronicles of Narnia. Start with the 2nd book, The Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe. And then move on to everything else in any order that you please. But I recommend 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Except you start with 2. So it's like 2, 1. And then if you want to read 2 again, you can read 2. So it's like 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or 2, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or just read it. Secondly, many of you guys know that I am a big photography nerd, and not just any photography. I love film photography. That's why I got this book. Read this if you want to take great photographs of people. There's actually a prequel to this called Read This If You Want to Take Great Photographs, but I think I lent it to Chloe. They are very similar books, but this one has emphasis on portraits. And you will see as you flip through the pages that each page is a lesson, and each page has a photo illustration for you guys. And it's not only super educational, it's a well-designed book. I left a bookmark on Be Ready and Waiting. Find the right spot and the action will come to you. Yeah, this is a really good book. I'm relearning lots of good stuff right now. I think I'm gonna take a break and just read this. Bye, let's use the Carpe Diem. No, I'm just kidding. Third, if you are a boy and you want to learn how to be a manly man, get Mansfield's Book of Manly Men. It's an utterly invigorating guide to being your most masculine self. No, it's not about how to work out or to grow a beard or to tailor a nice suit. It's about great character traits of a great man in here. No, I do not think I am there yet, but I think I am working on it, and this book really helped me to do that. So the book starts with 4 traits that every manly man needs to have, and then it goes on with different other character traits that are exemplified by different manly men in the world. There's friendship, there's presence, there's legacy, there's wildness, there's sacrifice, you know, there's just all these different. If you are a dude, get, read, and apply this book. The world will be blessed to have lots more manly men in the world. And no, don't get me wrong, I don't mean dominating men, I don't mean men who are better than women, I don't mean any of that. I mean gentlemen who act out of love and want to serve others and are just, get it. Fourth, because I am all about seizing the Carpe Diem and about exploring, which I actually just talked about in my Anchor episode today, which you guys should listen to, plug. I chose Carrie Smith's How to Be an Explorer of the World. It's a super great book about, you know, life as a scavenger hunt and how to explore the world and how to collect stuff and just different like exercises that you can do while you're exploring the streets of, you know, your normal neighborhood, the places that you visit every day, but looking beyond the mundane and the normal and seeing nooks and crannies of the beauty in the world. For example, exploration number 22, people watching. Sit in a public location and document people you see for 1 hour. Take detailed notes, make sketches of one item that stands out most about each person. I mean, how exciting is that? You get to see more of the beauty of people around the world, the strangers that you barely even notice. You will really notice them and really notice how beautiful they are. As I have said many times, the longer you look at something, the more beautiful it becomes. And this book helps you look at the world more beautifully. Does that make sense? Lastly, number 5, my all-time, one of my most ever favorite books ever, The Little Prince by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, or I don't know if I pronounced that right. I tried. There are millions of copies worldwide. For sure, you will find this in any local bookstore. It will not be hard to find. So this one, hey, you know, there's a really nice autumn leaf bookmark in it. This one was printed in 1972. It's just about as old as my dad and my mom. I read The Little Prince every year on my birthday, and each time that I read it, I learn something new about growing up, about life, about keeping a childlike heart and seeing the world with the eyes of a child. It's an amazing book that everybody, young or old, or young and then when you are a teen and then when you're an adult and then when you are everyone of all ages should read it at all ages. It's about a little prince and how he makes his way from his home in an asteroid all the way in outer space down here to earth and the things and people that he encounters along the way and the lessons that he learns and how he ends up meeting the author of this book who was stranded in the desert. One of my favorite scenes is when the little prince tames a fox here on earth. "I'm looking for friends," said the little prince. What does that mean? Tame. It is an act too often neglected. It means to establish ties. To establish ties? Just that, said the fox. To me, you are still nothing more than a little boy who is just like 100,000 other little boys. And I have no need of you. And you, on your part, have no need of me. To you, I am nothing more than a fox like 100,000 other foxes. But if you tame me, then we shall need each other. To me, you will be unique in all the world. To you, I shall be unique in all the world. If you want more, just buy the book and read it. It's a wonderful book. That's it. I hope you learned something. I hope you found a book that now you really want to buy and you want to read. I hope you gained something from this video. If not, then like it anyway and subscribe it and comment it and share it and favorite it. Please continue to pray for me. Thank you so much for all of your support. I hope that on Wednesday, I will be able to publish a video where I am not in pain while I am talking. But yeah, I will see you guys then. Let's seize the carpe diem together, guys. Bye!